Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to talk about JavaScript API for Snowflake stored procedure. This is a second video from the Snowflake stored procedure. JavaScript API for Snowflake stored procedures. Snowflake stored procedures are written in the JavaScript. The API application program interface consists of JavaScript objects and the methods in those objects. Here, Snowflake provides the four types of objects from the JavaScript API or stored procedure API. The first one is the Snowflake, second one is the statement, third one is the result set, and fourth one is the SF date. The API enables you to perform operations such as execute a SQL statement from the stored procedure, retrieve the results of a query, retrieve the metadata about the result set. Object Snowflake. The Snowflake object is accessible by default to the JavaScript code in a stored procedure. That means you do not need to create this object. This object contains the methods in the stored procedure API or JavaScript API. So no constants from this object in the stored procedure API. That means we have a methods from the Snowflake object, but no constants. The second object is statement. A stored procedure statement object provides the methods for executing a query statement and accessing the metadata such as column, data type about a statement. At the time of the statement object is created, the SQL is parsed and prepared statement is created. So the with this statement, at the time of the statement object is created, the SQL is parsed and prepared the statement is created. Prepared statement also will get created. This object contains the methods in the stored procedure API. No constants from this object from the stored procedure API. So the next object is the result set. Third object from JavaScript API or stored procedure API, the result set. This object contains the results returned by a query from the stored procedure. The results are treated as a set of zero or more rows, each of which contains one or more columns. Like suppose if you execute a select star from employee, then you may have the more columns. Otherwise, if you specify the column name select employee number, then you may have only one record, one columns. The term set is not used here in the mathematical sense. That means the mathematics, a set is unordered, whereas the result set has an order. Okay, a result set is similar in some ways to the concept of SQL cursor in other databases. Typically, after you retrieve a result set, you iterate through it by repeating the following operations, like call next is the one of the method to get the next row, and retrieve the data from the current row by calling the methods such as the get column value. So you have to pass the column name or position, like starting the index with 1, or you can specify the column name. Some of the methods of result set objects are similar to the methods of statement objects. So I will make one more video about the all the methods available from these objects. This object contains the methods in the stored procedure API. The same way, no constants from this method also, this object. The last object is SF date. JavaScript doesn't have a native data type that corresponds to Snowflake SQL data types like timestamp LTZ, timestamp NTZ, and timestamp TZ. Like if you see some other data types like number, string, so for them there are equivalent JavaScript data types are there, but especially for these three data types, there is no native data type in JavaScript. Hence, Snowflake is providing the sfdate object in place. So when you retrieve a value of type timestamp from a database and want to store it as a JavaScript variable, then we have to use the Snowflake defined JavaScript date type sfdate object. The sfdate Snowflake date data type is an extension of the JavaScript date data type. We have a data type in the JavaScript, but it is not, you know, native support for Snowflake data type, date data type, as mentioned about data types. Sfdate has extra methods. This method contains the methods in the stored procedure API. This object contains the methods in the stored procedure API. In similar way, this object also no constraints from this object in the stored procedure API. So that's all from this video. I will make one more video about all the methods available from each of the object. Thank you for watching my video.